My comment is that as it's a primary school, I really press my query painting. Sorry, I query paying for an artist. Surely this is a project that school wants to do with the school budget.
Just to take you down to the first one.
Yeah, well, should we take the person from the group first and then ask for counterpart?
Okay.
Say that the project hasn't come from Mount Primary. We've approached Mount Primary and asked them to work with us. Mount Primary are putting in £1,000 into the project, so they are contributing towards that. And the payment of an artist will be a sessional worker, as in with the Spirit of Chinese.
Chris?
Yeah, can I just say that the value of having professional artists going into schools can't be underestimated. You know, this gives so much more to a child in terms of their education if they are able to work professionally, professional musicians, professional artists, professional dancers. And again, the school is contributing, and I think the theme is fantastic, and I'd really like to support, you know, us getting behind our local professional artists, actually. Thanks.
That's a lady.
It also talks about the volunteer costs, the volunteer or the costs.
If that's the group.
When you're involving volunteers, there are costs because it's about being able to offer people their transport fees so that anybody can volunteer, even if they're on benefits and actually can't afford it. So it's about making it as equal as possible. So it's about transport costs.
I wouldn't disagree with what Councillor Spring said about children being helped by professional musicians and artists. Have no quibble with that. But I reiterate, if Mount Primary want to do a project like this, and they've obviously been approached by somebody looking to do it, if they want to do it, they should find money out of their budget.
Should we move to a vote?
Okay,
can I suggest that we make the payment of £2,000, removing £500 to remove the cost of the professional artists and volunteers?
Could I actually move that we give them the full amount, so you've got obviously two different.
There's no need for that at all, is there? Okay, so. I'm going to put the two figures to the vote. Those in favour of giving the full amount of £2,500. And those in favour of Councillor Blakely's proposal of £2,000. Two. We're really going to have to. Okay, it's carried that we give the full amount. Thank you very much. Number 22, Sew and Show. They've asked for £1,401.11, very precise bit there. Comments from the floor, please.
Yes.
Are we agreed?
Yeah, agreed.
Right, number 23, Wirral West Boys Club. They put in a bid for £1,984. Is there any comments from the floor? Start off with Adrian, then we'll go to the
West Wirral.
The council council of the children out of West Wirral, which was more constituency now people to do more to Wallasey. But for the council would have been closer to West Wirral.
That's a phrase.
Sorry, just to reiterate for the final time, this is where we're saying something hard to because we also have in Wallasey and Brighton West Wirral City Council.
Yes, sure.
I'm happy to support this.
Okay, now that we know it's in the constituency, are you happy to support this? Yeah, okay, that's agreed. Number 24, Sandbrook Community Centre, Fun & Fitness. They've asked for £2,350. Any comments, please?
Once again, support this chair and just this is the only facility that human people within the area of the Sandbrook estate have to actually access any facility. And it's based in Sunningdale, which is the part of the community centre that is as a whole. And they'll occupy after that hall. But I know they operate 7 days a week and they provide some magnificent services to human people in Sandbrook. And that's why the force is for this.
Do we first support this? Agreed?
Agreed.
Okay. Just ask how will we actually do it for how much have I got left? Right. Okay, W25. Great Escape, Bombs and Green Great Escape. Drop in, they ask for £1,695.62. Is there any comments from the floor, please?
Can I ask for this information? I've been reading it to put it on the news because I'm very gracious on will for people in that
have you got somebody in from the group?
I run the group tomorrow at church. I've been having a mental health problem myself, and a great escape from the past. I got out of my taking the medical. And I'm there to help for what I can do. But a lot of time, I don't get paid, I don't get a special for it. I'm there, I'm asking to come see him. And but I'm just doing as much as I can. And I'm not, I don't really need loads of money. I just need to say specific things. I'm a facilitator and I tell people what to be done.
Thank you, Friends of Red Lane, cemetery restoration of the cemetery gates, they've asked for a full amount of £2,500. Any comments on this? Any other comments?
No.
Right, in light of there being no objections, I'll probably support this bid in full. Agreed?
We've got a good morning, yeah.
What happens when we get to the public's work office? It's obviously unfair on what happens to be the last
Right, I think in that case, if you've done an overspend, what we'll do is we'll finish off.
Chair, sorry, could I bring Caroline in because we do have an answer for that?
The Commission had an underspend from Wallasey Rice Ideas Fund, which I've just calculated at £3,930.15, so it may be that the Commission wishes to add this to Wallasey Rice Fund.
Yes, how much do we want that to be on the
We're up to £49,495.
Right, so okay, so we've still got five bits to go through, and we've got £4,000.
Chair, what is it we agreed to appear, or will we have to revisit what we previously agreed? Because as I said again, it's not fair, is it? Which by the actual fact is that the last number and this amount of money they give it.
And I'll bring Emma in on.
I think, Chair, the most appropriate thing is for you just to continue as you are, rather than looking at a running total. So you deal with all of the bids equally in terms of the criteria that you've been using. There is one underspend, and again, you can send us away as officers actually to look at where we can potentially support the bids in other ways in terms of meeting the committee's aspirations.
Yeah, I'm not happy to read this. Try and shave money off then, that's not the right way to do things. What we agreed, I think the suggestion was to wait for this project to carry on, adjudicate on the rest of the bits, and then this additional funding needs to be found and the others to see whether they can target the account.
Yeah, I agree, that's the only way to move forward, so we'll just carry on that. So, the restoration of the cemetery gates, we've had that discussion now. Are we agreed to fund that? Is that agreed? I've only got a couple of voices. Is anyone against? Right, that's agreed. Okay, number 77, that doesn't qualify, that's my understanding. Okay, number.
But yeah, well, I do realise that that is a good one. Even though I just felt the same as such a show, the service is here to satisfy. It's a good one to show that I'm sure of course the situation is past the plan. So it's likely that it's not a good show.
Thanks, Jeanette. Okay, number 28, lease on community allotments. They've asked for the full amount, £2,500. Any comments from the floor of the
Yeah, hi Rob. I actually are part of the group that we can maintain communal area developments, and it's very difficult for wheelchair users to get down at the moment, they just can't get to it. So great, we should have a wheelchair stay.
That's a great idea. No. Okay, are we all in agreement to give them the full amount? Thank you. Number 29, Wallasey Central Park, everyone's park improvement scheme. They've put in a bid for £2,237. Again, comments?
Fully support the bid, Chair.
Adrian?
It is the second biggest park in Wirral.
Yeah.
And other parks have had a rather more favourable treatment for many years. This park has just won the green flag, and I think we really want to protect it and continue to improve it. So support it.
Okay, can we agree to support this bit of fund? Is that agreed? Thank you.
Agreed.
And 30 Friends of Vale Park, Joe Time. They must have £2,500. Is there any feedback or comments from that?
Yes,
do we have anybody in from the group who can speak on this tonight?
Can we refer this for further information?
Yeah, I mean, the point's been made.
The fact that it's not for paying.
Right, if it comes back, it's not, but we'll be the full amount. Okay, we'll defend this. It comes back that the money isn't seen as wages. We'll agree with the full amount. And if it is, we'll check that there is. Is that agreed?
Can I just ask, it's been going for 60 years. How has it been
Right, and finally, number 31, Parish Church of St. Thomas the Apostle Group. They asked for the full amount of £2,500. Obviously, this is a bit out of this card. Any comments on that, Jeanette? Do we have anybody in from St. Thomas's that could answer that?
One reason or another, for whatever really good reasons, that bid is
then isn't implemented or less is spent and so on. So that shouldn't prejudice the committee's view, but we will make sure that we get the facts. It's the other reason that though you are approving full amounts on these bids, we do have quite rigorous monitoring of how money is then distributed, which has to be against actual spend. So the money that you allocate is against what has been agreed, which is why actually bids totalling a bit more than you have in total are actually okay. But we will look at that to make sure that the committee can meet all of its commitments.
Jeanette, I mean, I don't think anyone in the room would doubt that the way it's doing. But all I'm saying is we do fair, because if they've bid for this in the past and they've spent the money and they've done the way, but now it just needs, you know, paying more maintenance and carrying on, that's a separate issue. But whether my understanding is we want to see if that money has been used for what it's originally intended for. So what I'd recommend is we defer this to get this information first. Yeah? Now, if it turns out that this is additional to those bids, that's also needed, that we have spent the money in the way that it's intended, can we agree this bid in full?
Yeah.
Okay, moving on to a more palatable side, say, paperwork as well.
All these people who put in for these fundings, were like the fellow in the service, the plates, so we keep everything going. And on behalf of all the funds you give out, thank you very much.
Thank you, much appreciated, and also happy for coming along tonight as well. Agenda item 6, the integrated transport block, the council programme for funding.
Thank you very much.
David, if you should handle the government's operational data to necessary is to assist them in a more targeted approach to traffic enforcement. And also to paragraph 2.42, to make members aware of that, the issue that was raised to officers on the subject regarding an incident at Ian Fraser Walk, where sadly a gentleman was injured on the and the scheme there will be to provide additional signage and carriageway markings on the four-way area to try and provide additional separation for pedal cyclists and pedestrians. So the manager will need to make some decisions on which schemes that they support and prioritise that allocation of funding. Happy to take questions.
Questions from Kevin in House of Lords and then Councillor Wilson.
Just on 2.41, does that mean the sign not working now will be reactivated and work? Does that mean the traffic sign now that our property is so low? We've talked a lot of numerous correspondence myself about members of the community about them not working and activated. Will this money go towards bringing them back into use, or are we talking about the ones that are actually only performing when they're working? Because if not, constituency wide, isn't it?
I understand that the signing is talking about. The department does not have funding to continue to maintain this additional technological sort of on the roadside. The items that members have put forward from previous neighbourhood fundings. This funding will enable us to continue to download the data and use the data for operational reasons. If the farm's not working, we'll have to look at other ways of trying to get those signs working. My understanding is the vast majority of them are the one you just referred to.
I would say that
members have made decisions in the past to allocate negative funding towards highlighting the speed of traffic on roads in communities where the residents of all those issues fall into. The signs do a great job of alerting people to the fact that they're travelling above the threshold speed, and the police don't appear to have the resources to enforce everything that we would wish. Providing data to them to say there is a problem at this road at this time may give them a better opportunity to target those particular problem sites. But that's all it will do. I'm not asking the police to do their job, we're just giving them better tools to say where they can enforce what resources they have.
Thanks. Just following up on that point, and I made this point last time. If that £20,000 is spent, the speed indicating devices will still operate. They will still alert people to the traffic speed, say slow down or tell them the speed they're going. It just means the data collection stops.
Correct. Can I just point out that members could choose not to spend a full £20,000 more than they choose to spend a smaller amount of that money. Sites, and we would look at finding an equitable resolution to which sites across the constituency that we would recommend.
I hear what you say. I don't entirely agree that the data is useful, because I don't entirely agree that the police react to it. And when we write to highways engineers as elected members alerting them to problem roads, the answer we get back is always to say there isn't funding, but we will have emergency sites. So we're already alerting them, we don't need to alert them again. We can alert emergency site police, we can ask for CSOs to pull up the traffic cones in hotspot areas. As elected members, we can do that directly with the police. So I'm opposed to spending that £20,000.